Welcome back to Magic Crossover presented by Starry. I'm Kendra Douglas alongside the one and only Wendell Carter Jr. How are you?
Great. Glad to be here.
Thank you for taking time out of your day to come talk with us. Along with this podcast, we really like to kind of just really get to know the guys a little bit more outside of basketball and just kind of like what you like to do, what you're into. So let's talk a little bit about just, you know, living here in Orlando. What has been the fun part that you've enjoyed doing without the basketball part of it?
Honestly, one thing when I first got here that I found out about Orlando is that they have really good e-spots out here. Out in the cut, you gotta kind of know the area to know where to go to eat. Everybody thinks of Orlando, they think Disney World, but I feel like Orlando is, you know, secretly going to be like one of the top food spots in the future. You know, we're winning, you know, the city's being built up, so I think, you know, a lot of things are going to start coming to Orlando for sure.
Do you like save all of them on your Instagram whenever you like?
Oh, 100%.
Easily. That's like food spots. Yep. And I'm like, okay, I got to go there. So I feel that for sure. Yeah. When you know, this season's been a lot. It's been so much fun. How have you enjoyed the season so far? The traveling and everything. What have you liked about the season so far, though?
I think just our bond as a team, I've really liked, like, you know, even off the court, you know, we spend a lot of time together. Like, you know, we go out to eat together. You know, we do a lot of things together. So, you know, when we're on the road, you know, sometimes it can get lonely, honestly. And, you know, luckily we got a team that, you know, 1 through 15, everybody likes each other. So, you know, it definitely makes it a lot easier. You know, those long road trips, you know, those 2-3 week road trips, you know, it makes it a lot easier when you got a team that's, you know, want to be together and just have fun together.
Top 5 favorite places so far.
To eat? Oh, you're talking about travel. Top five. I'm gonna say New York.
Okay, yes.
I love the shop, so I'm gonna say New York.
I love shopping in New York. It's a dangerous place for me to go.
It's very dangerous.
I literally feel like everyone on my bus makes fun of me because I'm like trying to check 10 times bags.
Oh, yeah.
Because I'm shopping nonstop. Oh, anyway, yeah. Okay, so yes. New York.
LA for the same reason.
Yes.
I love to shop in LA. Miami.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. Miami's a vibe.
Yeah, thanks. I love going back to Atlanta.
That's okay.
Go back to the crib.
Mm-hmm. One more.
Fifth one. Sneaky. I'm going to say Houston for real.
Really?
I'm going to say Houston.
I kind of like Minnesota. Houston.
Okay. Yeah. Hear me out.
Just.
Yeah. Okay.
How. Yeah. I think where we stay, one.
Oh, yeah. Fire.
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 And just kind of when you go outside, you're like, oh.
Yeah.
This is sneaky lit.
Yeah, sneaky lit.
Yeah.
It's sneaky lit. Yeah. Okay, yeah. That's a good See? Word for it. No, it is. It is.
I'm like, okay, yeah. Jalen.
Yeah.
You didn't tell us. This place is kind of cool.
No, it is pretty cool.
You just kind of like walk in here and you're like, oh, I'm from Minnesota. And we're like, Jalen. All right.
It's a sneaky good, like, the last time we went there, like, mm-hmm. I went to a really good like restaurant after the game. I'm like, oh wow, like it's not bad.
Right.
It's not bad.
That one, Minnesota will give you. Yeah. We'll give you like your sticky. And then on top of that, we got to see Paolo like get to learn that he was an all-star there. So that was kind of cool.
Yeah, that was dope.
So I think our experience was just kind of like fun in general. But no, I think that we've had such a fun season. It's been so fun getting to know you guys a little bit. One thing I was interested in is you wanted to be a pilot?
Yeah.
That is so cool. What made you want to do that? And what kind of, you know, what was the reason for that?
When I was a kid growing up, it was kind of random. I remember one day we got on an airplane for like one of the first times ever in my life. And I walk in and I like look to my left, you know, you can see the cockpit and all that. And I'm like, wow, that looks really cool. But I didn't think nothing about it. You know, got on the plane, flew wherever we went. Then on the way back, I stopped and was like kind of staring. Then the pilot came out. He was like, hey, you wanna come in and like look at it? I was like, oh yeah. So I came in, I looked at it. I'm like, whoa, this is like super dope. And like, he showed me all the buttons he got to press and all that. And I'm like, wow, that's dope. So fast forward, I was probably like 12. I told my mom, I'm like, mom, I think I want to be a pilot. And you know, a mom, she gonna tell you, oh, you can do anything. Just put your mind to it. So I like started reading books on it. Like she started like buying me like little easy read books about pilots. And I started learning more about like African-American pilots and then all that stuff. And then I realized I hit a crazy growth spurt And I knew that that was no longer going to be a thing for
just
me.
Just kidding.
Yeah, so it was a very short-lived thought.
Dream?
Yeah, dream. Very short-lived dream, but we're here now. I think this dream is pretty good, too.
Yeah, I think this one's doing well for you. And I mean, you get to fly a nice plane all the time.
Exactly.
Okay, so I want to create Wendell's, like, air service. Well, I just gave you a name. So if you could create your own, like, air service, what would the name be? I feel like you've thought about this.
Dale's Air.
Okay.
Dale's Air.
Dale's Air. Inside. Are we doing a color scheme? Like, what are the seats looking? Green?
Yeah, green.
Is that like your favorite color?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay.
Money green.
Money green.
Yeah, yeah,
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. I like that. I like
the white
money
accent.
Okay.
Yeah.
And is it going to be like all kind of first class seats? Are we putting like the chair, like the tables in there too? Like, what are we doing?
We're going to do two tables.
Okay.
With four chairs.
Got it.
We got to have a couch.
You got to have a couch.
Got to have a couch.
Yeah.
We're going to probably put like four beds in the back.
Okay, okay.
You know, someone want to go to sleep.
Okay.
And then the rest going to be captain chairs though. I don't want no regular seats.
Got
all
it.
Captain chairs, you know?
And then the food service, we're doing good food.
We're going all out. We ain't about to do what Delta American be doing. We're going to go all out. We're going to have like seven options on the, you know, you're going to get like two.
Okay.
Delta, so
yeah.
We're going to have like seven, eight.
I feel like Dell's Air is what we should implement next year for all of us to travel.
Yeah.
I don't know how or who we go to about that, but I just want it to be known that if it comes into fruition, we said it here.
Yeah, we said it here.
You came up with the idea.
Yep.
So you should totally get all the money for it.
Yeah, absolutely.
And I will get a piece of that because I'm the one that came up with all of this. I just want it to be known if Dell's Air comes into fruition. Don't forget the little people.
It's happening. It's going to happen. We're going to make it happen.
Perfect. I love that. So you were talking a little bit about like your dog too. You're a dog person.
Yeah.
I feel like that's kind of cool because not too many people can have dogs on a team. How do you balance that? And do you love having a dog here in Orlando with you?
I honestly do. When I have a bad game or a bad day, whatever the case may be, that's someone I can always rely on. When I come home, he's going to be the same no matter what. Very energetic. It makes me smile whenever I get home. When it comes to traveling stuff, I got someone who actually comes to the house and gets them.
Got it.
So, just kind of takes them while we're gone and then brings them back whenever we come back. So.
What's your dog's name?
Rocky.
Rocky?
Yeah.
My dog's name is Winner.
Winner? Okay.
Rocky and Winner.
Rocky and Winner.
I think your dog would sit on top of mine, though.
He probably would. He probably would.
He's like a mini golden doodle.
Oh, yeah. My mom actually has a mini golden doodle, actually.
Really? Do they get along? Do your dog? No.
Mm-mm.
Oh, well, we learned that right away.
Yep.
All right.
My mom's mini golden doodle is like sassy a little bit.
Oh, okay. So. No, mine's super chill.
Yeah.
Just wants to hang.
Mm-hmm.
But now that like I know you have a Rottweiler, I still feel like he would probably be like scrummed like under your dog somewhere. Like your dog's gonna sit on mine. We're never gonna know.
For sure. And he played too much sometimes.
And he
played
too much.
Yeah.
we were talking I wanted to ask you and mention we were talking about Dell's Air. Talk a little bit about your foundation though.
Yeah.
And just everything that you've been able to accomplish so far, especially I think I read that like you are like the first athlete to create a curriculum.
Yeah.
That's dope to say.
Yes. So.
What? Don't call him Wendell Carter Jr. anymore. Call him Wendell Carter Jr. the first athlete to create a curriculum. I want that on the back of your jersey from here on out. Talk a little bit about that because that is so cool.
Honestly, I give a lot of credit to my foundation manager. You know, she brought the opportunity to me. You know, I've always bounced ideas off her. Like whenever I'm out in the city or I'm at home watching TV and I see something I'm like really like passionate about, I'm like, oh, yo, like let's hop on this or let's do this or let's have this camp. So one day she bounced that idea off of me like, yo, we got an opportunity where, you know, we can tackle the aviation space. You know, it's very much untapped into. A lot of people are not talking about it or doing anything in that space. So I'm like, yeah, let's do it. And I used to want to be a pilot. She didn't even know I wanted to. And I was like, yeah, I actually wanted to be a pilot when I was a kid. And she was like, really? I'm like, she was like, yeah, it's easy. We're doing this, like, no doubt about it. So she made all of it happen. Honestly, I give a lot of credit to her. she really just made this thing happen.
How cool is it though to know that you get to impact so many kids' lives with this?
It's so dope. Cause it also gives a different perspective too. Like, it's not the whole trying to help kids play basketball, not trying to help kids play football or, you know, turkey drive. It's not like the typical foundation work. Like, this
it's
is something
so different.
Like way outside of the box. No one talks about it, thinks about it. So I'm just super excited. Like, this is just the beginning. Like, our goal is to have this at every school in Florida. And then outside of Florida, then, you know, wherever else it takes us, yeah. That's what we're trying to do.
I love that you know, you could easily have said, no, I want to do it in Atlanta.
Yep.
You could have just given all of your time there. Why was it so important for you to continue to give to Florida and just be here?
Honestly, when I got traded here, when I met the owners, you know, they were really big on giving back to the community. So I'm like, it just made it easy for me to just kind of tap in with them. Like, yo, I'm just going to kind of do the same thing that they're doing. Like, you got an ownership that has the same goal in mind of just helping underprivileged kids, people in general. Like, it just makes it way easier. There's no reason for me to, you know, go back to Atlanta, which I do stuff in Atlanta still. But, it made it really easy for me to kind of just tap into that. And they kind of helped me out with where to go to, who to ask, you know, questions to, and all that kind of stuff. So they made it real easy for me, for sure.
Has the feedback been, like, received really well? And has it made you feel just more welcome? Like, you feel like Orlando is, like, your home?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. Like, just me walking around the city, me going out to eat maybe, or, you know, anything, going shopping. Like, people are recognizing me, not only for my basketball, but just for my foundation, too. Like, you know, someone at the camp yesterday said something to me about my aviation program, saying, like, yo, like, you know, what schools are you know, doing the aviation programs at? Like, are you going to be able to go across the all over Orlando? Like, what's your goal? And it's just super dope that, you know, the city is paying attention to us. Like, so I'm just super excited just to, you know, be in Orlando. And, you know, we're winning now, so it makes it a lot more easy for people to like us. So.
That is true.
Yeah.
I imagine that, like, when you're getting into this role, they always talk about how, like, the NBA is a business. And how important it is for you to really find your niche, find your home. Having your family here, has it really just made your transition into the, not your transition, but just being here in the NBA and your growth, has it made it just feel better and just kind of like you feel good because you get to have all the opportunities here in Orlando?
Yeah, absolutely. Having my people here is definitely makes life a lot easier. You know, they've been with me pretty much all my life, you know, and college. They came to North Carolina with me. They came to
you
Chicago.
You can't miss Wendell's mom and dad either. They are always there. I'm always like, hey, y'all. Like, you can't miss them. They are great people. Nah, they're always there.
Nah, they're my people for sure. And like, they just been, you know, holding me down, you know, through this whole process, through the ups and downs, the me getting traded, you know, all that kind of stuff. So like, they're real ones for sure. And they've made this whole process a lot easier for me for sure.
What else do you want to accomplish within your time in the NBA?
Definitely won a championship. You know, I think most people would say that. I think personally, though, I want to – well, I kind of told myself this probably like my third year in the league. Like, if I'm able to look back on the previous year and say that I got better, you know, that's all I can ask for. You know, like, whether that comes with accolades, that's – out of my control, but as long as I'm able to look back each year and say I've gotten better, maybe it's mentally, maybe it's emotionally, maybe it's physically, maybe it's the numbers I'm putting up, whatever it is, as long as I'm getting better, like I'm content for sure.
Awesome. And with that, I feel like that's where we can end off. And Wendell, thank you again for taking time out of your day to come chat with us. Thank you for watching Magic Crossover presented by Starry, and make sure you stay tuned for our next episode in a couple weeks. Thanks.